Hi, this is Abhay from Manupatra. In this video, I'm going to show you how does a judgment appears in a Manupatra layout. What are the different IPs and editorial input that are available within a layout of a judgment in Manupatra? As you can see from this picture, that Manupatra has a unique way of presenting a judgment to its users. This is to ensure that our user is able to use the gamut of features that Manupatra provides to find the most relevant document, to jump seamlessly from one document to another, or simply double click on any word and you will be able to find a dictionary meaning. The idea is that we want to provide our users easy to navigate tools available at right, so that they don't have to think much. The system does the heavy lifting for them. They just have to click on a button and the system will automatically take. For this, we'll be using, which is Vodafone International Holding BV versus Union of India 2012. This is the Manu citation of that. Now let's go to Manupatra. This is how a judgment looks in Manupatra. This is the date of the judgment, the party's name. On the left hand side, this is the Manu citation. So Manu citation is our own citation. Once you click onto this one, this will give you an equivalent citation. So you might be using a different journal and copy, or your library, code library has a different equivalent citation. So we give you more than 325 plus journals. So all these volumes are covered from one till today. On the right hand side, there are some features. These are very, very important features. They are present in top of any Manupatra judgment. We'll come to them. So this is another feature. This is Judge Analytics. This gives you a brief insight on the outlook of that particular judge. These are the counsel's name. Counsel's name are again hyperlinked. So if I want to see where Mr. Nakul Diwan has appeared recently, I can click onto this button and it will give me those cases. Direct taxation. So this, any judgment that comes in Manupatra is given a particular subject. Have 50 subjects. This particular judgment is given a topic of direct taxation. What are the catchwords? Which are the words which are commonly coming in this judgment, so where this judgment was cited in future judgments. So once I click here, I'll be transported to the cases where this was cited. These are all the acts that were used in this judgment. They have been mentioned here. So a relevant section is another such editorial enhancement that our editorial team does. It segregates the main key acts apart from the rest of the acts. So the judgment, all these acts were used, but actually the judgment was based on just 3-4 acts. So we have segregated these for you. We have also given a separate search if you just want to see the judgments on the relevant section. Now this is cases referred. Cases referred gives you all the cases that were referred in the judgment. Everything is hyperlinked from here. Now this is also very interesting that Manupatra gives you the entire timeline of a judgment. So this judgment started from Bombay High Court. So that link is given. If it has overruled any case, that is also given here. Another, if it was challenged by some other case, this is again was challenged by a writ, and this is the citation for that judgment. Citing reference is also available. Citing reference gives you how many cases were discussed, mentioned, or affirmed in this case. Once you click on to this one, this one case was relied on. So if I found this judgment relevant, is another judgment that I want to read. And these were the judgments that were mentioned in this. This is the case note, which is also known as the head note. So any Manupatra judgment will have a head note or a case note. Okay, now again, subject category is also there. This subject category is given by Supreme Court. We captured that in the judgment. This is a referred notifications. So Manupatra is the only database that is covering both the central and state notification circulars. Very easily you will be able to jump from one document to another. Everything is available to in one place. This is industry wise. So our judgments is also given a particular industry, say telecom is one, bank industry is another. From here you can see that this particular judgment was authored by Kapadia sir. This is the body of the judgment in Manupatra. So you can simply scroll down, or you can use this navigation bar. So I want to go to the bottom of the page. So this is easily, it will take me to the conclusion. Thing is hyperlink, say section 195. I can just click and I can see section 195 of the Income Tax Act. If I want to read the judgments from Supreme Court on the same, that also I can do. A case law that has been mentioned will also be hyperlinked. So this is a Manu site. So this is a small wheel type of icon that is present in front of any citation. Just click onto this one. And this gives you the treatment for this case. So this particular case was delivered in 2007. After then, it has been cited 229 times. It has been discussed 51% times, discussed 27% times, relied on 13% times. Positive treatment, or more it has been dissented, or more it has been relied. So all those treatments also from this small icon you will be able to access from. If you are reading a judgment and you come across a word that you don't understand, so there is an inbuilt dictionary function available in Manupatra judgments. Just double click on this word and there will be an option for no more. Just click on to this one and this will give you the legal dictionary meaning of this word. Okay, so this can be applied for a Latin phrase also. If you don't understand for a particular phrase, you can select that phrase and the no more option will be available. Let's move to the top of the judgment. So as I told you, there are certain features that are available on top of any Manupatra judgment. So one is this one. So if you want to go back to the results page, this is your button. Another one is if you want to read commentary on this judgment. Sometimes judgments also have commentaries. So Mr. PM Bakshi, if you want to read the commentary, you can read it from here. Another one is important para. Now important para is an artificial intelligence feature. This important para gives me the list of the key paragraphs of the judgment. So these are the key paragraphs. How are these key paragraphs? Because these are being quoted in subsequent judgment. So this is the paragraph and this has been quoted. So if I found this paragraph, 82 paragraph of this judgment, very helpful, I can click on to this button and it will give me where this paragraph has been quoted. Now I can, this is the more recent judgment, the 2018 judgment by Supreme Court. I can click on to this one and I'll be able to read this judgment also. So the idea is to give you the list of the important paragraphs so you don't have to read the entire judgment. To find something relevant to you, you can always find more judgments on the same point. So this was important para. The next one is cited in para. This basically gives you whether this case has been followed in some other case or not. This case after 2012 has been cited in 240 cases. So this is the list of all the judgments where this has been quoted. It goes a step further. So it also gives you in which paragraph of the judgment it has been quoted. So this is a Madras High Court judgment which is quoted in 11th paragraph. Similarly, this is authority of advanced ruling. So this gives me the paragraph. This is the 23rd paragraph. It is quoted Vodafone. And so the idea is that you don't have to read the entire judgment. If you find this particular paragraph helpful, you can click on to this one and you can go on to read the entire judgment. This is cited in para. It gives you the list of all the cases where this case has been cited in future. Let's move on to the next one, which is interactive timeline. Okay, let's just do case map first, then we can come to interactive timeline. So case map is a very interesting feature. This gives me the 20 most relevant judgments for my case. So this is, let's take this as a timeline. So this is a Vodafone that came in 2012. On the left hand side are all these cases which have been cited in Vodafone. So it was discussed, this particular case has also been discussed, this has been mentioned. Okay. On the right hand side, after 2012, what happened? As soon as I bring my pointer in this particular case, State of Rajasthan versus Goten Limited, this was dissented. Okay, so it will give me the treatment. What treatment was given to this case? So I'm getting two information from this. Number one is that this was cited in this case. The other one is what treatment was given to this. I'm interested in this judgment where it was dissented. Now here I can see that all these judgments have also been cited in this case. A different treatment was given to these cases in this judgment. There is a legend that is available here. So if you want to see the cases where this was affirmed, it is shown by green. This case is a bigger balloon, so this has been cited more. Okay, this particular case has been cited more. Let's click on to this. Okay, now this becomes the center. This has been cited 100 times and now I can follow this case. This case was relied on this case. This case was distinguished in this case. Similarly, once I click on to this one, now this becomes the, this is by the help of the technologies like artificial intelligence and visualization tools that you are able to go multiple layers ahead. So this is a case map. This gives you the list of 20 most relevant judgments for a particular judgment. Okay. Now let's come to the next one, which is authority timeline. Now authority timeline is similar to case map, but it gives me the entire list. So it gives me all the 240 judgments. So there we were getting just the 20 judgments. Now here you can get the list of all the, this can further be refined. Like I want to see where this judgment was just relied, where this was dissented. So there are two judgments where this has been dissented. So again, the size of the circle of importance here, this is a slightly bigger circle, which means it has been cited 70 times. Smaller circle has been cited 2 times. So this is authority timeline, which gives me a feel of all the cases where this judgment has been cited in subsequent judgments. So this feature is highlight catchwords. So this gives me the list of the common words that are occurring in this judgment. So if I want to go to directly to text avoidance, wherever text avoidance is coming, I can. Similarly, this is the PDF feature is also available. So if you want to take out a printout or if you want to save it on your desktop, this will be looking like this. So the Manupatra branding is there. So we have been there for 20 years, a very recognized brand in the market. The name of the subscriber will also be there at the bottom of it. So coming to the next one, if you want to send this document as an email to a friend, to a colleague, you can just use this one. Just click. If you just write the name of the second party and it will directly go as the attachment, you can leave him a small message from here. So this is, if you want to send an email, use this one. Sometimes for your drafting, you require the word format of the judgment. So that is available from here. So if you want to download the word format with or without case note, you can download it from here. You can always copy paste from here, so that is no problem. But sometimes the word format is also required, so it can be downloaded. The next one is the sticky note. So say this is the 77th paragraph. I want to highlight this. You can do this from here. Just select a pen and you will be able to highlight it, add highlight. And you can also leave a comment. Say I want to save it in the tags folder. You can save this. So once it's saved, you can access it from here. So sticky note summary. You can select whatever judgments you have saved in the tags folder. So this is, suppose I'm doing my research on a particular topic, so I can leave a trail. So I can, in this particular judgment, I've saved this paragraph. And this is tax important. So another, okay, so this is the recent one that we created, CGP share. And download it from here. You can mail it to a friend, to a colleague. So everything is again hyperlinked. So easily you will be able to navigate using this document. Okay, so this was sticky note. Let's move on to the next one, which is if you want to save it in cloud. So this can be saved in your Google Drive or your Dropbox. So the next one is if you want to save this document in manupatra.com. So just click on to this one. And you can create any number of folders, or you can directly save it in, say, DirectX folder. I want to save it here. So this will be available to me. Access that folder that can be accessed from here, my saved documents. And this is DirectX. And here is our judgment. So this is very helpful because sometimes you're working in your office desktop and you go back to your home using your own personal laptop. So this is available in manupatra.com. We have also a very efficient app both for Play Store and iTunes. So you can download that and you will be able to access these folders in your app also. Coming to the next one, which is the print replica option. So print replica option is available in most of the judgments. Here what we do is we provide the scanned copies of various journals. So Manupatra has acquired some journals. Scanned PDF copy is available from these journals, like the unreported judgments is one. So this is the scanned copy is available as it was reported in the unreported judgments. Now the next one is the judice copy. Now judice is basically the court's copy of the judgment. So this is coming directly from the Supreme Court website. Okay, so what's happening these days is a lot of publishers are changing the paragraph numbers of the judgment. So Manupatra does not do that. If you have any doubts, if you seek any clarification regarding a spelling or any, you can just come here to the source copy and you can check. You can always download this and print it out. It can be accessed from here, print replica, judice. Coming to our last feature, which is a small pie chart in front of the name of the Honorable Judge. Just click on to this one. From here, you will be able to see some graphical representations which will help you analyze the patterns of the judgments written by Honorable Judge Saab. So if you want to see the year-wise judgments, so once you flip it, you will be able to see that he has authored 6 judgments and 83 were the part of the bench judgments. Flip this for the subject-wise, you will be able to see that he has written 70 decisions on direct taxation. Once you click onto this one, this will give you the entire list. You want to see which are the counsels that have most appeared from him. This is R.V. Desai, sir, has appeared 225 times. Now, if you want to see the disposition of his judgments, to see the disposition-wise judgments, how many he has given in favor of SEC, how many he has disposed of. So all these figures can be seen from here. The next one is judge citing. So who are the judges that he tends to cite the most? The next one is the judge cited by. So who are the judges that are citing sir the most? Citing reference. So how many times his decisions have been affirmed, discussed, dissented in Supreme Courts? A similar database is available for the High Court. So this data is available to everyone in public domain, but Manu Patra has tried to do is they have tried to present this data which is much more accessible to our end users. So this is Judge Analytics can be accessed from this button. So as you might be able to appreciate from this, that each Manu Patra judgment has many features, editorial enhancement, visualization tools. So all these tools have been added over the years. So we have been there in the market for 20 years now. And for this 20 years, we have been continued to grow and learn from the feedback that we have received from our loyal clientele. So I'd request next time you open Manu Patra, just open your favorite judgment and quickly scan through all these features. And soon enough, they'll become a second nature for you and will be a great, great help to you as a legal researcher. Let's do a quick recap of what we learned in this video. Number one is cases ruled and reversed. So any judgment which has overruled any judgment, that will be there. So citing reference gives you where a case has been cited in future cases and what treatment was given to that case in terms of relevance and applicability. Judgment in Manu Patra has a case note, which is basically a head note, which gives you a summary of the judgment. Double click on any word, it will give you the dictionary meaning of that word. Manu Patra database is comprehensively hyperlinked and cross-referenced, so it's very easy to jump from one document to another. If you want to take out a printout, this is the PDF option is available. If you want to send a mail as an attachment without going to your email, there is an option available for that. So if you are doing your drafting, that Word option is available where you can download the Word format of the judgment. It is there where you will be able to highlight a part of that judgment and you will be able to leave a comment on that judgment. You can, if you want to save a judgment in Manu Patra Cloud or in your own Dropbox or Google Drive account, that is also possible. If you want to see the source of the judgment, so print replica option is available that gives you the judge's copy along with a scanned copy from another judge. Any judgment that comes to Manu Patra is given a particular subject category and industry category. There's a mentioned in button available if you want to see where a judgment has been cited in other cases. Gen Analytics gives you a graphical analysis of the pattern of the judgment that the Honorable Judge Saab has been writing. You'll be able to find all the acts used in the judgment under one tab. Relevant section tab, we segregate the relevant sections for this act from other acts. The list of cases is a separate tab for the cases referred or any notification, if any notification has been referred. As if you want to check the review petition or Supreme Court status on any judgment, that is also the part of the layout of the judgment in Manu Patra. I thank you for giving us your time for this video. If you have any queries, any feedback for Manu Patra, please feel free to contact us at contact@manupatra.com.